All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is smelting. Got about 4 ounces of sterling silver in there. All scraps and failed projects. To start, you need 2 different gases. I use MAP gas and oxygen. Just getting set up here. Process I've been doing for quite some time now. My dad actually taught me how to do this. Right here you got the crucible, your long handle. You got your ingot mold. You can see it's pretty heavily sooted, fairly filthy. That's what's going to hold the molten silver, and that's how you end up with an ingot at the end. Just a big old heavy-duty torch, nothing special about it. You can get it at Canadian Tire for about 90 bucks, give or take. Now, to prevent any sort of oxidization of the metal, borax flux is what's used. Just sprinkle some on there. The flux basically acts as kind of like a vapor barrier. It prevents any sort of junk, any sort of crap happening to the silver as you're melting it. So before I do anything with this, I have to soot this. What the soot does, you can see all that nasty soot. Well, that stuff acts almost like a lubricant. Prevents any sort of sticking of the molten metal to the steel ingot. It also heats up the ingot a little bit. That also prevents some sticking. As you see, it doesn't take too long for some of the stuff to melt. only that one big, slightly molten, mass. Getting pretty close to pouring temperature. As it gets close to that, what I usually do is that heat up the ingot mold, preheat it just a little bit, not too much. I'm not too sure how well the camera's picking it up, but molten metal. Because the crucible is so hot, it'll still keep it molten when I take the torch away from it. You notice I'm preheating the pouring spout. That just makes it easier as the metal is pouring over it. If it pours over and that spot is cold, it'll flash cooling and cause, well, it's not good. Not too sure if you can hear the popping and fizzing, but that's the silver flash cooling. Brilliance is that knob isn't actually hot. Like I said, this is 4 ounces of material here. And there you have it. You got yourself an ingot. Well, I do. How,